If you're a collector of anything, you're bound to have certain things in that collection that are very sentimental to you, but most people would call them kinda weird. So I want to show you guys the weirdest things in my Halloween collection. Hey, what is up, you guys? It's Nick here from the Lost River Drive-In, and today I want to show you guys the weirdest items, or most sentimental items, whatever you want to call it. They kind of all fall under those umbrellas in my Halloween collection. Now, before I get started, you're probably sitting here thinking, oh, what editions of movies is he going to pick? It's actually not movies mostly at all. I have one movie, and everything else is like oddball stuff in the Halloween franchise that technically is a part of my collection because it's Halloween, and I own it because it's Halloween. So the only movie that I grabbed was the Miramax Psycho Killer series. Now, I have no idea why I still have this, aside from the fact that I can't get rid of anything Halloween. Because I have a problem when it comes to Halloween, none of this stuff I'm ever going to get rid of. Even if I don't revisit it, even if I regret buying it sometimes. And this is one of those. See, at the time, this was right around when Echo Bridge got the rights, and they were putting Halloween 6, H2O, and Resurrection out on DVD and Blu-ray. Well, this Halloween Psycho Killer series came out. Well, Miramax, technically. And it was 6, H2O, and Resurrection, but they added Jamie Lee Curtis's Mother's Boys, which is like a mystery thriller type movie. And I saw it, and I was like, I gotta buy it. Because at that time, I was just collecting for collecting's sake. That was when I was a teenager. If I saw something out in the wild that had Halloween on it and I didn't own it, I was picking it up. And this is one of those. Now, they also did the Halloween collection, which is 3 films on DVD, and I own that as well. So it's the same as this, just this has Mother's Boys. Totally bare bones. It's one disc. It is, I mean, why? Why do I have it? I don't know. Yeah. Now, I just want to say really quick, before I get into some of the weirder stuff, to a lot of you guys, if you like Halloween, it's not really going to seem weird. You're actually probably going to think it's cool. But like, if you're not a huge Halloween fan, you're going to be watching this and you're going to be like, dude, you're kind of weird. And like, yes, I am. So the first thing I want to show you guys is this Halloween 5, The Revenge of Michael Myers, which looks like it's a VHS. It looks like a VHS case. Like, oh, you got a VHS in there. This was actually from Scarefest when I went with Christian and we had a whole group of people there. And they had a booth of, you know, a bunch of horror movies in cases like this. And the thing about it is, when you open it up, it's like chock full of goodies. So first, you've got a bunch of Halloween 5, The Revenge of Michael Myers stickers, which I haven't put on anything. And when I grabbed this for this video, I just realized that these were still in there. So I need to put these on something. You've got magnets. These were actually on my fridge. I need to put them back on once I'm done with the video. And there's a couple other magnets in there. There's a scythe. There's just the font logo. There's a little miniature VHS. It's like almost like a paperweight. And I actually have this sitting on top of my shelf. So I grabbed that down for it too. And there was a keychain, which is actually on my key ring for my car. So I thought that was really cool because like Christian and I had no idea what this was. Like, at first glance, you're just thinking, oh, it's going to be VHSs of horror movies. And it's not. There's a bunch of little, like, collectibles and, I don't know, oddball stuff. And I just thought it was really cool. So, and of course, whenever you package it like it's, you know, a VHS and it's a rental, like, I mean, you got me. Now, the next thing was actually a gift from my younger brother. He saw it and he thought of me. Now, he's a death metal fan, and I've never really been into that heavy of music. And I guess there's a band called Sanguisabug, and they had a EP or something come out called The Devil's Eyes, and he got it and gave it to me. And I have this displayed on top of my shelf simply because it's just that iconic photo of Nick Castle with the mask on the top of his head drinking the Dr. Pepper. Like, obviously playing on the nostalgia for Halloween, and that is the entire reason my brother got it for me. And again, technically doesn't really have much to do with Halloween itself, aside from, you know, what's on it, but I had to do it. I don't know. Next up, these things were at Spirit Halloween a couple years ago, and I think they have, I know they have more now for like Child's Play and other stuff. I don't know if I've seen these. If I did last year, I could be wrong. But it's these little Halloween candies with the Halloween 2 branding, of course. And as you can hear, there are still a lot in here. I did eat a couple. I'll try to open this up for you guys and show you for anybody that doesn't know, that's not familiar. They're like knives. And these have oxidized, so they're definitely not edible anymore. But it was like these little knife candies that, I don't know, I just thought it was cool. So now, next to where the Halloween 5 little paperweight thing sits, this sits right next to it, and it's just Michael's cute little mug. Next up is gonna be a Japanese one sheet that my buddy Phil got me, and this thing is super, super cool. I have this up, this is actually framed up above my movie shelves, and yeah, it's a one sheet. I do have to cover really quick before I flip it over because the shot of PJ Souls is on there. But I love this. And it was actually to celebrate the rebranding of my channel to the Lost River Drive-In. He was like, I want to get something for you because, as you guys know, he was helping me at the beginning and doing editing and whatnot. So he got this for me as a gift. And it's gorgeous. I love this thing so much. And again, shout out, Phil, if you're watching this. Thank you very much. Kind of weird, you know, but that's me. And when it's Halloween, I don't care. Now we're gonna get into some stuff that is like really sentimental and like definitely super weird. Like this is the bulk of the, oh, that's kind of weird, and I don't care. The first thing, if you guys have been to South Pasadena, you'll know how it's set up when you go to the Myers house. And there's a couple of like areas where there's mulch and bushes and stuff like that right in front of the house. And there are rocks in there. So the first time I ever went to visit it, I grabbed one of the rocks out. This rock is from the front yard of the Myers house. And I remember coming back, we were going through LAX, and I had this in my bag, and they had to take my bag, TSA did, and they took it out, and they weighed it and everything to make sure that it didn't weigh too much for me to take it. I was about to be like so heartbroken and upset, and they're like, nah, it's good, it just makes the cut. I was like, thank God. Also though, kind of crazy, you can't bring tweezers on an airplane, but you can bring a thick ass rock. So I don't really know, but yeah, this is a rock from the Myers house. It's just really cool. This sits on top of my shelves as well. I'm actually really happy to own it, even though it's super weird and you know, kind of OCD of me, but that's me. And then keeping in theme with that is the paint chips from the Myers house. Now, if you guys are looking at this and you haven't seen the Myers house in person, you're probably like, why are they blue? Because the house got painted blue. So obviously when it got moved in the 90s, it got a paint job. And they also carpeted some of the interior, but everything else pretty much looks the same. Even the baseboards of the house on the inside look the same. But yeah, it is blue now. And before anybody gives me shit and says, oh my God, you ripped off paint chips from the Myers house, that's vandalism. Maybe technically, but this was actually before it got its most recent paint job, because I was just there a month ago and it had been painted again. And this was actually a spot where it was already like peeling. So I was just like, oh, I'm just gonna take a couple of the paint chips. So you can say what you want, you can make fun of me, or you can look down on me, but I own part of the Myers house. So like, technically, like what you're looking at right here, right now, this was on your screen. This. Every time you watch Halloween, this right here, this is a part of the Myers house. I own it. Now let's dive even further into the weird and obsessive. And the next is a piece of the hedge. Now I actually have two pieces of this, but the first piece I got when I went for the first time a couple years ago, my ex-wife still has it. It's in a book. She was using it in a book as a, I believe, a bookmark. I don't know, but I know it's still there, so I need to get it back. This is from my most recent trip there. And look, if you're a Halloween fan and you make it to South Pasadena, California, you're going to take a piece of the hedge. Now, last that I remember, the guy that owns the hedge house is kind of an a-hole, so I didn't really stop to ask, and there was no one outside. As I was walking past it, I was like, ripping it off. If anything, we're helping you, dude. We're keeping it trimmed. So yeah, I'm also gonna press this. All of this stuff that I'm showing you guys, believe it or not, I'm gonna have like a weird, like, Halloween wall at some point that's like, oh, here's this with a photo of what it is and whatnot. So this is a piece of the hedge. And next up is going to be a piece of the tree from Halloween Kills. Now you might go, what tree? There is a moment in Halloween Kills where Kyle Richards is hiding up against a tree. And if you guys watch my video from just the other day where I, you know, went through the filming locations, I got in the exact same spot that she was. And I made sure after I took the video, I was like, I am going to grab a piece of bark that was like kind of already hanging off at the bottom of the tree because that's where she would have literally been. So is it weird and like kind of obsessive for me as a Halloween fan? Yeah, of course it is. But Kyle Richards, her back was on this and this was in the film. And you know what? As a weirdo nerd Halloween fan, that means a lot to me. So a piece of the tree from Halloween Kills. Now, next up is something that I personally did not expect to find. When I went to the compound where Laurie Strode's house for Halloween Kills was, I was looking for the bricks. But I should have known when Sean Clark made a video, it's got over 100,000 views. If anybody watched that, even if just 5 people watched it and went there after they watched it, the bricks were gonna be gone. Well, they were gone. I searched and searched and searched this lot of land looking for something to take, something that would have been a part of the movie, whether it was intentional or inadvertently. I was searching and searching and searching. And when I went to the foundation, the spot where it looked like the foundation for the porch was, because it was more toward the front, buried in the dirt, there was a piece of a stick sticking out, but it was kind of wedged down in there. So I kind of pulled it up slowly, trying not to break it, and I didn't break it. And wouldn't you know it, this little stick right here, and I'm going to try to make sure you guys can see it. It's charred, as you can tell. This was burned. Obviously, that side's not. This side was burned and singed. This little stick got its battle scars from the fire that they set to the house in Halloween Kills. This was part of that fire. This was a result of that fire that is on screen every time I watch Halloween Kills. Now, how do I know that? Well, first of all, it's an empty lot and it's private property. There's actually a smaller house right down the driveway from it. You can see it. I was actually kind of weirded out being there because I didn't want to get yelled at or someone come out with a gun or something. So, and there, no fire pits, nothing like that. There was nothing on that plot of land. You literally could not convince me that that was not part of it, because it was where the foundation of the porch was. It was wedged in the dirt, and pulling it up, that baby's burnt. That is singed. That's charred. Look, burnt. So as weird as it is to some of you guys listening right now, I'm sure it's super weird to some of you. To me, this is really cool because I know that this little twig that I'm holding, it was on fire. Because of the fire in Halloween Kills. The fire that's on screen burned this twig that I'm holding in my hand. So, make fun of me all you want, but I'll sleep soundly. What's the moral of the story when it comes to this video? Well, I'm weird, and I'm obsessive about Halloween, and I have been for like about 20 years now, and that's just kind of my curse. My gift, my curse, whatever you want to call it. I have no shame in the fact that I have some weird sentimental things when it comes to the Halloween franchise, because the franchise means a lot to me. And especially if I can own pieces of that history, screen used things. And again, inadvertently, but if I can own pieces of that, that means a lot to me. And I know if you're a diehard Halloween fan, it means a lot to you too. Because I have heard people say to me like, oh my God, you have paint chips from the house. Like that is so cool. Because it just means a lot to us weirdos. So yeah, I'm weird. I embrace it. I let my freak flag fly when it comes to the Halloween franchise. But I want to hear down below in the comment section what you guys think about some of the weird items that I own in my Halloween collection. Is it too weird? Or do you want some of them? Do you plan to go to those locations and do the same thing? I want you to comment down below, even if you're going to make fun of me for some of the weird things I own. Please leave a like on the video. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. This is Nick, the number one Halloween fan on YouTube. And I'm pretty confident in saying that. But thanks for stopping by. It's time for me to pull out.